Hello and welcome. The 3DS saga seems to have no end. For those who didn't follow what happened last month, first came Lemonade, a 3DS emulator that seemed very promising, as it combined part of Citra's code with Citra MMJ, a lighter version, ideal for more modest hardware. However, soon after, two former Citra developers, Pablo MK7 and GPU Code, accused Lemonade's developer, Gamer64, of copying tens of thousands of lines of code from the Citra fork without giving due credit. This scandal caused great drama in the community, and the Lemonade community was destroyed, leading to the discontinuation of the emulator. But Gamer64 didn't give up and launched a new fork called Citra Enhanced. I was already considering taking a break from 3DS videos due to the recent turmoil, but now we have this new project to explore. If you want a direct comparison between Citra Enhanced and Lime 3DS, please leave a comment. Citra Enhanced comes with a number of improvements that set it apart from other versions of Citra, especially for Android users, but also some for PC. Here's a summary of the main changes that have been implemented. Android improvements, opacity controls. Now you can adjust the opacity of the touchscreen. Size and position adjustment for buttons. You can resize and reposition individual buttons to suit your preference. Screen rotation, a feature that allows you to rotate the screen for better viewing. Fixes for Mali GPUs, improvements imported from Citra MMJ to ensure better performance on devices with these GPUs. Haptic feedback, added for touchscreen controls. Tweaks dialog box, allows you to apply hacks temporarily during gameplay to improve playability. Oboe audio backend, for clearer and more consistent sound. Resolution change, now you can adjust the resolution during gameplay. Hotkey for screen swap, to facilitate navigation. Restructuring of resume and pause emulation. Improvements in stability when pausing and resuming. UX improvements. General improvements to user experience. Increased frame rate limit. You can now accelerate the game up to 400% for greater speed. Android and PC improvements. Skip slow draw and skip texture copy. Hacks from Citra MMJ that help improve performance and prevent lag. Raise CPU ticks. Adjustments to increase performance on older devices. Priority boost, a hack to prioritize the execution of important processes. Anaglyph for LCD screens, improved display for devices with LCD screens. Core down count, a hack to reduce the load on the CPU. Various code fixes and improvements, for greater stability and performance. PC exclusive improvements, improved game title display, making it easier to identify and select games in the interface. Before we start with the tests, please leave a like to help with the video's engagement. If this is your first time on the channel, consider subscribing so you don't miss new content every week. If you want to know how Citra Enhanced performs with problematic games, this video is for you. I ran a series of tests on some games known for presenting challenges in emulation and captured the results with a 5x internal resolution. Let's see how this version of Citra handles these situations. Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon, the performance was solid throughout most of the game. The pixelator worked without issues, without causing slowdowns or crashes. However, I noticed that in the mansion's exterior area, there are shader problems, especially during rain and when the thunderstorms light up the scene. This problem occurs less frequently in Lime 3DS. Inside the mansion, gameplay is smooth, with no major issues. Fire Emblem Awakening, I was positively surprised by the correction of shader compilation problems during battles. There were almost no stutters or delays during the action, making the experience much more enjoyable. If you're a fan of this game, Citra Enhanced might be the best option. Kid Icarus Uprising, this game has also been fixed in Citra Enhanced. The gameplay is accurate, both during flight and while exploring the city. The number of stutters was lower than in previous versions, offering a smoother gaming experience. Resident Evil Revelations, for one of the most challenging games in terms of emulation, Citra Enhanced did quite well. Entering new areas, the rendering was almost instantaneous, with no noticeable delays. However, I recommend playing the native PC version if you can, as it has superior graphical quality. Citra Enhanced looks promising, especially with the recent improvements. There are still some issues, such as shader problems in Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon, but overall, the performance was good. If you're considering a 3DS emulator for Windows, Citra Enhanced is definitely an option to consider. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.
There's blood coming from the ducts.